has a smile that can light up a whole arena and a performance that can electrify a crowd. Quebec's José Chouinard leads the ladies into the free skate. But two former champions want to win in Saskatoon. Karen Preston won in 1989, and last year it was Lisa Sargent. Only one can be a champion in 91. In the pairs competition, Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler are currently ranked number one. They would like to convert that into a gold medal at the Worlds in Munich, but a gold here in Saskatoon is not a guarantee. Former champions Christine Huff and Doug Ledray are on a mission, too. You'll see them all this afternoon as CTV Sports puts more figure skating memories on ice. 20th anniversary of the Canadians here in beautiful Saskatchewan Place. Greetings, everyone. I'm Rod Black, along with Debbie Wilkes and Johnny Esau. Debbie, first to you. The ladies are getting ready for their free skate. This is going to be one heck of a race.
A horse race, indeed. We have the three top ladies, José Chouinard, leading the original program at this point. Karen Preston is in second place, a former champion. And last year's defending champion, Lisa Sargent, is in third. Anybody can win, right down to Tanya Bingert, who's in fourth place. She's formerly from Vancouver, skating out of the Preston Club this year. I think it's going to be whoever can hold their nerves under control.
Another fellow who has had a hard time controlling his nerves this week is Johnny Esau, back in his old stomping ground.
All right. Well, I'd like to first of all congratulate Herb Jeroniak of Saskatoon because he became the first Saskatchewan male skater to win a Canadian gold championship.
Johnny, the pairs competition, Landry and Johnson, the defending champions, aren't here any longer, but it's still anybody's game.
Well, it used to be the private preserve of Landry and Johnson, Huffman and Gray, Brasseur and Eisler, but as you say, they're gone. Wheeler and Renzies have moved into third place. But with Eisler having won second place last year in the World Championships, that means that Canada will now send three pair to the World Championships in Munich this year. And if they stay the way they are right now, the top three are going to go. But I feel there's going to be an upset between first and second.
Regardless of how they finish, it's going to be a great show. And to tell us more about the pairs, let's go down to ice level with former dance champion turned broadcaster, Tracy Wilson.
Lloyd Eisler has a very serious knee injury. He tore the cartilage in his knee while playing hockey in December. Now, because of that, he has to wear this very large knee brace to protect his knee. He's going to have to wear this knee brace for the next 2 years. It has affected their training. He had to take a month off of the ice, and he has not been allowed to practice any of his jumps until he arrived here in Saskatoon. Now, Isabel Brasseur, his partner, has been very concerned, of course, about the injury, and her confidence is a little bit down because she knows she's not as prepared as she usually is coming into this competition.
We'll see the pairs later, but first, let's go to the hot. The ladies free skate, José Chouinard, Lisa Sargent, Karen Preston, and the rest are up first.
Coverage of the Knive.
After the ladies' original program, José Chouinard of Quebec is leading the way heading into the free skate. Karen Preston of Ontario is second. Lisa Sargent from Alberta third. British Columbia's Tanya Bingert is following. Lisa and Annie Saint-Hilaire from Quebec is fifth. The order of skate now for the final four. Remember, this counts for 66 and two-thirds of the final mark. Lisa Sargent first, the defending champion, then José Chouinard, Karen Preston, and finally, Tanya Bingert. How does Lisa feel about now as she warms up, Debbie?
Well, she's looking very good. The jumps seem to be coming together nicely. Her coach, Michael Jeranek, is right in front of us here. And as she approaches him for last-minute instructions, her face is very calm, very peaceful. I think she's under control.
We touched on the nerves of steel these ladies will need. This lady had a little problem with nerves last year.
She's also having a good warm-up. José Chouinard knocking those triples off. And that delightful look on her face. She really loves to skate.
She wanted to be calm and cool. She looks it right now. Also, Karen Preston, who is second. Some think here that maybe she was even first after the original program.
She's getting last-minute instructions from her coaches, Ellen Burka and Taller Cranston. Taller, you can see, just firing forth all the last-minute details. Might be a bit too much.
Well, here is the defending champion, Lisa Sargent, from the Royal Glenora Club in Edmonton, Alberta.
Even though she's third after the original program, she can sure make it to the top. She's got a difficult program planned, but she has elected at this point to leave out the triple axel. Clean is more important. Triple Falcao Lisa has checked out of. She has chosen to double whether the takeoff just feels good. Skater has to make a very nice decision. Lost all her motivation. She's creeping. There's the attack on the triple toe, but I think it's too late.
Will she be champion again? Lisa Sargent from Edmonton, Alberta. Clubmate Kurt Browning watching.
She certainly left the door open for the other girls.
Not only at stake is her Canadian championship, but a spot to the world team. Only two ladies will be heading to Munich in March.
It seemed to be a very hot and cold program. The triple toe combination to begin with was very good, nice and strong, but then something happened. Going into the first triple salchow plant, she just gave up. There was some moment as she sat on the takeoff edge right here where the rotation was simply stopped. The body started to lean a little bit. She had to pull out.
She didn't seem to have the zest she had when she did her original program. The marks for technical merit, as low as a 5-3, several 5-4s, and a 3-5-5. And for presentation, a couple of 5.4s, an artistic impression, and 5.6s. But will it be enough? She moves into first place right now, but Schwinnard and Preston and Bingard have to skate yet.
Your overseas suppliers are on hold.
That came crashing back down to earth in the long program. Will it happen to Jose Schwinnard again?
Here's a skater who just loves to skate. She beams throughout her program. She has a very refreshing style, lively and youthful.
She was first after the original program. 21 years old from Laval, Quebec.
Plan.
Jose Chouinard. Third at the Canadians last year. She had some problems with her free skate last year. Ironically, this time she had her problem not during a setup to a jump or anything like that. She just fell.
Well, if you have to fall, better it's not on an element. But those kind of falls are the ones that hurt. You learn over the years to kind of go with a fall out of a landing of a jump. But here, let's try to see what happened. It almost looks like she just caught her edge, tripped on the toe pick.
Yep.
It seemed as she went into the Mohawk turn, the foot was not fully around, and the edge just caught. But then to continue on, I mean, very gutsy to go on and complete the next triple toe with very little speed and that kind of shaky feeling a skater gets from a fall.
We'll see if her Canadian championship hopes fell as well with these marks for technical merit. 5.6 as low as and as high as a 5.8. Now for artistic impression. Jose, 5.6s, 5.7s, and 5.8. Jose Chouinard is the leader ahead of Lisa Sargent, but still to skate is Karen Preston, and the door now appears wide open as Tyler Cranston wishes her luck. Couple of problems. Now Karen Preston's turn.
Here's a tough competitor. She's really out to do a first-class job, but she's got to skate clean. No mistakes. She begins her program with her toughest element, the triple flip. Good.
1989 Canadian Ladies Champion. She will not be the champion in 1991. Karen Preston from the Toronto Cricket Skating and Curling Club.
Her face tells it all.
She sure had her chance, Debbie.
She did. Everybody had left the door open. All she had to do was go out and skate. She seemed to lose direction in the program. She had been skating so strongly and with such power. This was where it all came tumbling down, the triple flip jump, the opening jump, free leg going wild and crazy. She just never got back on track, or not until it was too late. The final combination, and something she threw in, was the triple toe, which was successful, and then she continued on to a double toe combination, but you can see the body so far forward on the landing that there's no flow coming out of the jump. The skater standing almost on point.
And with two places only available for the world team, it's unlikely she will make one of those as well. Technical merit marks, 4.9, some 5.2s and 5.3s, and a 5.0. For artistic impression, as low as 4.8, some 5.4s, and a 5.5. She is third right now behind Lisa and Jose Chouinard, who possibly right now could be the Canadian champion as we await one more skater. If there was ever a scenario for a Cinderella story, this could be it. Tanya Bingert, fourth after the original program. She has watched three ladies have problems. If she could go clean, could she win?
It is mathematically possible, depending where the judges rank the other three ladies. This is a good one, too, beginning with Wally Double Axel. Program is set up to get Tanya's legs underneath her, so here is the first triple toe. Lovely.
She loves the pressure too, Tanya does. She says the heavier the competition, the more she likes it.
Two.
skating championship, fourth after the original program. She was ninth at the Canadians last year, sixth at the Canadians in 89. She trains with Carrie Leach at the Preston Figure Skating Club.
I thought we were off to a real good start.
I thought perhaps the upset could happen, but...
Tiny body problem on the landing of that triple, but she is a real powerhouse. She covers the ice very quickly. Very good technique. Makes me wonder, as we look at the approach to the triple lutz, look at the lean on the body, the free leg shooting forward instead of back. Skater needs that leg back for balance. Makes me wonder, the building is very warm. That naturally affects the ice surface. Softer, though, usually figure skaters like it softer because it gives it some bounce, but it makes it very hard to breathe.
This is pro ice here in Saskatchewan Place, as opposed to jet ice. Pro ice is a little softer. 5.1, technical merit, the lowest mark. 5.4 is the highest for Tanya Bingert. The mark for artistic impression, 5.1, 5.2, 5.3, 5.2. She will finish third overall. That's a giant step from the skater who's from Richmond, British Columbia. Remember at the beginning of the program, we talked about the three ladies? Lisa Sargent, the defending champion, being one. All she could do was watch. Her fate was sealed, but she did finish second. A disappointed Karen Preston, who let it all slip away. And the winner, Jose Chouinard. She is number one in Canada, and she will go to the World Championships wearing the maple leaf in March. Ladies, free skate, Jose Chouinard, the Canadian champion, Lisa Sargent. Second place, Tanya Bingert. Great performance for her, moving up from ninth last year. Karen Preston was fourth. A lady who's always smiling and has an even bigger smile now. Here's Debbie Wilkes with Jose Chouinard.
Well, thanks, Rod, and I'm smiling because I'm here with our new Canadian champion. Congratulations, Jose.
Thank you very much.
And did you expect this to happen?
Well, I was expecting to skate it good because I was confident and I worked so hard this year. And I think I had good competition international. So I had a lot of confidence.
Did you watch Lisa skate before you?
Yeah, I watched only the last part.
And what did you think?
Well, I thought it was good, but I didn't see the beginning. Well, I thought it was really good, but, you know, I was more concentrating on me. So.
When you watch a competitor perform, does it help you do better? Do you feel like it gives you more confidence or more pressure?
Well, no, not this time, because I think I forgot what she did when I went on the ice.
Well, congratulations to you and best of luck at the World.
Thank you very much.
From the smile of a new Canadian champion to the intensity of Lloyd Eisler and Isabelle Brasseur looking to regain their Canadian title, they're ready. The pairs final will give us a lift at these Royal Bank Canadians. CTV Sports, growing up with Canada's champions.
Can you see champion on this little cutie? This is Isabelle Brasseur, and halfway across Canada is... Can you see champion on this little cutie? This is Isabelle Brasseur. And halfway across Canada is Lloyd Eisler. It would be a long time before their paths would cross. They would go in different directions for a long time, and then fate would take over. Isabelle skated with Pascal Cruchane for 6 years. Lloyd would win two Canadian championships during 9 years with Laurie Beyer. He won Canadians and a world bronze with Kathy Matusik. She retired, and he joined Karen Westby. Then depression hit. But university didn't keep his attention very long, and when he heard that Isabelle was alone, he went to Quebec just in case. It was like magic. Canadian silver in 88, gold in 89, bronze in 90, and then silver at the Worlds in Halifax. Now they're favored to win it all next time around. With the continuous support of generous sponsors like the Royal Bank to the Athletes Trust Fund, skating in Canada grows stronger and stronger.
He and his partner, Christine Huff, are in second place going in today's program. We have the final of the pairs competition coming up, but first, pairs perform their original program on Thursday evening. And there were two outstanding performances.
They are former Canadian champions. They were second and third before. But right now they are number two in the world, silver medalist last year, and ranked number one with the retirement of Gordeeva and Grinkov. Isabel Berthur and Lloyd Eisler. Silver medalists at the World Championships last year, Isabel Berthur and Lloyd Eisler, looking out for number one. This year, even with a knee brace, they can still dazzle.
They have been working extremely hard on their individual skating. The crowd standing up. This was an outstanding performance. Isabel's been having some trouble here in practice, landing the double axel jump, but it was spectacular today.
It didn't look too much that Lloyd's knee was bothering him in that performance.
Not at all. This was where I was looking at it, going into the very difficult backhand-to-hand loop. She does a twist over. Now watch Lloyd. He's moving very well through this from one foot to the other foot. And this is where he must be very careful coming through to the dismount, because any balance problem for him means a problem for Isabel. Here are their coaches, husband and wife team, Jose Picard and Eric Gillies, who look at skating every step, particularly Jose. That must have been the double axel.
It must have been. They should be clapping, too, because of the marks that they have received for required elements. Boy, oh boy, 5.7, 5.9, the range for their original program. And now, for presentation...
5'8" and 5'9" for Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler. Debbie, they're going to be awfully tough to beat.
I'm so happy for them.
Look out, Eisler and Brasseur and Menzies and Wheeler. Here comes another tandem that will have something to say this week. Christine Huff and Doug LeDray from the Preston Figure Skating Club and the Kerry Leach Table.
This is an unusual program, Rod. This is comedy done to classical music.
Poor Doug LeDray, but they are terrific. And they are on their feet in Saskatchewan Place. What can be said about that program, Debbie? It had a little bit of everything.
We're seeing such a change in every aspect of skating. Pairs are no longer the cut-and-dried acrobatics. If you haven't got the artistic, forget it. And Tuffy and Doug have worked so hard to improve all aspects of their skating. This beautiful overhead platter lift was done with amazing speed. Their ice coverage was outstanding. The flip-out, I mean, it's as good as anything you'd see in the world.
They had lifts. They had a spiral. They had a kiss. They had a slap. They had it all.
They sure did. The back outside death spiral was another beautiful element done right at the end of the program. And all the while, you're totally sucked into the theme of the program, right down to Doug's pratfall.
Great animation, too. Coach Kerry Leach.
Not only coach, but stepdad.
As well, that's right.
Carey is married to Tuffy's mom.
So here we go. The mark for required elements. Five, six. Five sixes and a 5-5 for Huff and LeDray. Can they catch Brasseur and Eisler, who were sensational as well? So it's a presentation. One judge went as low as a 5-4 and as high as a 5-8. It will not be good enough. They will be second behind Brasseur and Eisler, but it sets up a great finale to the free program. And that free program is upcoming. Here are the results after the original skate. Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler, silver medalists at the world, are number one. Christine Huff and Doug LeDray second, close behind Michelle Menzies and Kevin Wheeler. In fourth spot, Stacey Ball and Jean-Michel Bombardier. Sherry Ball, Stacey's sister, and Chris Wirtz. And Marie Savard-Gagnon and Luc Redé.
Thursday night in the fourth competition, Kevin's leg looked like it was giving him some trouble. Watch his legs here. They're buckling underneath them. Afterwards, he reassured Michelle that he was okay. I had a chance to talk to Kevin, and he said that his leg wasn't hurting him. He was just really, really tired. But he's been getting stronger and stronger each day in practice, and we're just hoping that he has what he needs for today's program.
Well, there you see Kevin Wheeler on the ice now, getting ready for the pairs competition. Debbie, this has become a battle of wounded knee here, with Lloyd Eisler and Kevin both having problems with their legs.
Although I must say that by watching warm-up and by watching practice, boy, you hardly can tell.
Here is the order of skate in the pairs free. Brasseur and Eisler will be first, Menzies and Wheeler, Ball and Bombardier, Huff and LeDray. How does that affect them, the order there?
I think it's easier to skate first out of this group, although it means you have to shorten the warm-up somewhat. Generally speaking, a six-minute warm-up for the first skaters, you have to take at least the last minute to get yourself composed, get the last-minute instructions from your coach, get your mind set on exactly what the job is to be done.
Lloyd Eisler, the eyes of a tiger, and you might say that because of that knee and the brace underneath, that Lloyd Eisler, nicknamed Herb, is ready for the challenge and brace for it.
I have to definitely think more about where I'm placing my leg when I'm stepping on it for crossovers or anything tricky. I'm more conscious, so sometimes I'm not aware of the audience as much because I have to concentrate a lot more. I don't really feel that the brace is any hindrance to me at all. I've had to change a little bit of steps and things like that, but nothing that to the eye that anybody would notice. For competition outfits, we did have the time and the material and the money to redo the left side of my pants so the brace would fit underneath for competition. I think they're probably looking at it, but I think by the time they get there, everybody knows that I'm in the brace by now, so it's not a shock to them. It might be the first session we get on a shock to them that they see my brace on the outside. They might have thought it would be on the inside, but some pants will be on the inside. Competition definitely will be on the inside.
And the brace is on the inside for this free skate. Lloyd Eisler and his partner Isabel Brasseur, first after the original program, they were the Canadian champions in 1989. Lloyd has been a champion with another partner as well, and our pairs have been strong over the years. The Underhill and Martini era, we can call it, from 1979 to 83. Then Kathy Matuszek and Lloyd Eisler winning in 84. Cindy Kuhl and Rousham winning from 85 to 87. Huff and LeDray in 88. They're on the ice warming up. Brasseur and Eisler. And then last year, Cindy Landry and Lyndon Johnson, who have retired. Menzies and Wheeler warming up as well. Kevin buckled the other night a little bit on that leg of his. He said, no problem.
I think pair skaters somehow have a death wish, especially the girls. It's unusual because the girls are the ones that are having to cope with these major throws that involve so many rotations and such distance. It's very hard on the body. It's unusual that it's the guys that are suffering the injuries.
There is a definite danger factor, as Christine Huff would know, with her back, and Doug Ledre would know, after suffering a double skull fracture, he actually had to skate with a helmet on at one time. He threw the helmet into the audience after his short program a couple of years ago. And there's the new Canadian ladies champion. All the pressure is off of her now. Josée Chouinard can sit back and watch. And we're ready to watch, too. The pair's free skate is next. The Royal Bank Canadians on CTV. Speaking of races, this could be one as well.
Urban Isabel taking the final swing. This is a very warm building in here today. It makes it difficult for the skaters to breathe. The body only works if there's oxygen getting to the muscles. And boy, oh boy, is it hot.
And it will heat up, too, as the order of skate comes. As we mentioned, Brasseur and Eisler will go first. Had a chance to go to the Preston Figure Skating Club a couple of weeks ago with Carrie Leach. Anybody who thinks that figure skating is all, well, just the artistry part and, you know, the working on lifts and that, should go out and watch some people skate, because these people work very hard, and the conditioning, I was just amazed by the conditioning they have. The fact that they have so much work to do under Carrie Leach, and he puts them through it, but it's a discipline. And I know that there's probably a lot of hockey teams and power skating skaters who don't go through half of the routines that the figure skaters went through that day.
Carrie and the fabulous team of coaches that he has at his school have the philosophy that there is no shortcut to success. The only way to get there is through hard work.
And a pair that have worked very hard. They are the current silver medalist world champions. They will be ranked number one when they go to the Worlds in Munich. Debbie Brasseur and Eisler.
A wonderful pair. Ranking number one in the world right now with the retirement of Gordiev and Grinkov. This program has a lot more control, a lot more artistic detail. Isabel has been working very hard on her individual skating, and the whole skating quality of the pair has improved. Skating to Destination Paris by John Tesh. The first lift, a triple lateral twist.
Thank you. Isabel Brasseur, Lloyd Eisler. And a standing ovation. He is 27, she is 20, he's 175 pounds, she's 95 pounds, and when Lloyd first competed in 1973, she was only 3 years old.
Problems here with the side-by-side double axle. This is the area of skating that worldwide has changed so much in the last few years for pair skaters. Not only do they have to have amazing lifts, beautiful death spirals, but they must also be good at this. Exquisite single skaters. A look at one of those outstanding lifts. And I think for Herb and Isabel, it is their lifts that make them so outstanding. The height, the carriage, total control, all showcasing Herb's tremendous strength and wonderful timing between the pair.
Technical marks weren't bad, considering they had a minor slip up there and the presentation. 2.59, the rest 5.8. They are the team to beat here at these Canadian championships. Third last year. Carrie Leach and a subdued Doug Ledray watching that performance. They do definitely have a chance here. And they will be the last up in the order of skate, so they have to watch everybody else. I don't know if that's good or bad sometimes, Debbie.
I guess every skater has their own way of doing it. Michelle and Kevin have a dynamite program planned full of difficult triple throws. Although Herb and Isabel's program was very exciting and great to watch, there were quite a few errors. The throws did not come off well, two-footed landings and a couple of positions. If Michelle and Kevin can do it, the door is open for them too, Ross.
And of course, the leg is always in question. Michelle Menzies and Kevin Wheeler. Fourth at the Canadians last year.
Speed is their trademark. They say that the hardest thing for them to do is to show expression and interpret.
Thank you. apiece. If they don't win a gold medal, they should get a red badge of courage at least.
Did you see his leg shaking?
It was wonky there at the end.
Scared me. I mean, I think that sometimes when you have to deal with something like that, you concentrate so heavily on how to get through it. Maybe that's the only way to go. All of the coaches, Kerry Leach, their choreographer, Susan McGregor, all came running up to them. Are you okay, Wheels? Are you okay? He says, yeah, we had to change in.
He has a sore wheel, that's for sure.
This the final throw, the double axle throw. He's concentrating so totally, keeping that left leg free of the ice. Kerry skated every step with him.
His reaction on their last throw? Yes. He has to be proud of them because there was so much talk of them not competing, not being here. And they did. And they are second right now behind Brasseur and Eisler. Here's Stacy Ball and Jean-Michel Bombardier from the Laval Figure Skating Club in Quebec. They were fourth after the original program.
Stacy has just finished skating in the senior ladies, carrying a very heavy workload here at the Nationals. This is the four and a half minute long program for pair. They begin with the triple twist. Three rotations in the air for the lady. Splitting to begin. Side-by-side double axle.
They were fifth at last year's Canadian. Do you want to bet that Menzies and Wheeler are watching their Bombardier. Debbie, that may be a worth a trip to the World Championships. We'll have to see. Lloyd Eisler, Isabel Berser skated with Ball and Bombardier. They won the fours the other day. They now await their mark for the free skate.
Michael Bombardier getting congratulations from their coaches, Eric Gillies. What makes this pair so outstanding is their great individual skating ability. As we can see here, the throw double axel, huge, stepping right forward into the side-by-side double axel. If there is a weakness in the pair, they have not yet spent too much time together like Lloyd has with Isabel. Takes some time. They train together. He's backing them all the way. They were hooting down here. Go, go.
And they won the fours together as well at these championships and at Skate Canada. Oh, Lloyd's pretty happy.
Yes.
Here are their marks. For technical merit, as low as 5.4. Some 5.5s and some 5.6s. This set of marks could earn them a ticket to Munich. 5.5s and 5.6s. They have moved into second place. Stacy Ball and Jean-Michel Bombardier. Oh, is Stacy happy? She's been a busy lady this week. She skated singles, she skated pairs, she skated four.
I'm a headache now. I must have, let me see it.
And now trying to get their ticket to the World Championship. Tuffy and Doug, Christine Huff and Doug Ledre, they won the Canadians in 88. They were third in 89 and second last year.
With this program, they have gone in a different direction, back into a more classical type of skating. They admire Underhill and Martini and that very romantic style that they have made so famous. When I first saw this program at Nations Cup, I thought it was kind of old-fashioned, but I have grown to love it here. It's improved tremendously.
Personnel, all the medical staff here to attend to Christine Huff, and our best wishes are with her. Debbie, when something like that happens, obviously silence hits this arena.
Let's have a look and see what happened. It almost looked as if she did not get full rotation. The pick goes in. They're skating very strongly. It has good height, but maybe not enough to complete the three rotations. And
Doug tried to keep her off the ice as well. They had an accident once before, and it was Doug, and Doug at the time did almost the same thing. He tried to prevent Christine from taking the brunt of the fall, and he was hurt badly. He had a skull fracture. Christine, looking at her hand right now, probably a little woozy as well. We'll be back at the Royal Bank Canadian Figure Skating Championships on CTV. Christine Huff, looking like she would like to get up, and she is being attended to. Can she continue?
The skaters would have the option. The referee may allow them to continue if she can report back on duty within a certain period of time, and if my memory serves, it's 5 minutes, then they can either choose to start the program again or pick up from where they left off.
What a devastating turn of events here,
wow.
Though. What a courageous young lady. She's going to try to skate this off. Now, if they do skate again, what's going to happen when they come back to that throw?
Well, I'll tell you, I wouldn't do the triple.
Let's go now to Tracy Wilson and Johnny Esau standing by upstairs.
You know, Tracy, we often keep our fingers crossed whenever the pairs competition is on because you keep expecting it's getting so dangerous, so athletic, so difficult that you wonder if it's going to happen. And it hasn't happened for a long time. All of a sudden, with two bad knees and then this, they want healthy leaders.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
Johnny, it's terrifying, and I know it's just exhausting for me to watch these programs. There's Christine. She's called Tuffy. That's her nickname, and you'll see why she's called Tuffy. The girls, I guess, you know, being up in the air in those lifts, anything can happen, and also in the throws. And I guess I'm surprised it doesn't happen more often. I know I'm glad I was a nice dad. That's all I can say.
Well, I was worried about Michelle Menzies because when Wheeler had her up there, and he's got one leg that the doctor told him he shouldn't be skating on, and she's up there, and we were worried about them. We weren't worried about Huffman and Dre because they were the healthy ones.
Well, Johnny, I know the girls just have total faith in their partners, and anything can happen, and here's Tuffy. She's getting ready to go. Well, let's go back down to Rod and Debbie and see what's happening.
Indeed. Tracy, Carrie Leach concerned. Not only is Christine Huff one of his students at his school, but also his stepdaughter. Doug and Christine Huff will go again.
They're getting a few minutes to try to get their legs back underneath them. Tuffy has done a jump on her own. You're feeling how the legs feel. They will make the choice whether to start again or whether to continue from the spot they fell.
We should mention that there are 120 doctors, nurses, physicians, massage therapists, paramedics, and ambulance personnel here at these championships. And if there is going to be something happening along that line, well, it's going to happen perhaps in the pairs competition because of the danger involved. Here it is again, Christine Huff in their opening throw. Doug really tried to prevent her from hitting the ice. Johnny, what do you think?
Well, I think her right leg caught his left leg just as she was coming down the land, and that's what threw him on top of her, and her head then cracked the ice. And that's what they were mostly afraid of, was whether or not she had suffered a head injury. But then after they checked her, and the doctors are there. There are lots of doctors here, and they keep very close tab on them. And she said, no, she's okay. So they then have to go to the judges to tell the judges that, yes, they can continue, would like to continue. And that's when you saw Terry Leach on the phone saying that, as far as he was concerned as the coach, he was allowing them to go ahead. Okay, Rod.
Here they go, Johnny. Let's wish them luck. Christine Huff still feeling perhaps some of the effects. This is a very resilient pair.
Their wings on the platter. Good.
Well, every heart skipped a few beats in here this afternoon in Saskatchewan plate.
How did they ever get up the nerve to do the triple twist again?
Okay.
Here it is. This time the good one. All the way around, better height, so more rotation.
Christine just said to Kerry Leach, I'm still dizzy.
Well, she made me dizzy doing this throw double axel. It was beautiful. And Kerry's reaction following, I don't think anybody really knew quite what to expect. And even the audience. There's Doug's mother right in front. Wow.
It was almost a miracle that they were able to skate again. They did. They captured the crowd in an emotional afternoon. They move into second place. They will go to the World Championships. Isabelle Verser and Lloyd Eisler are the Canadian champions.
When you need a reliable.
They aren't the Canadian champions, but they are champions of heart, that is certain. Huffin Ledrae, crashing, coming back as Christine was injured and being led away by her stepfather and coach, Kerry Leach. But they still won the silver medal here after the pairs competition. Isabelle Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler are the champions. Stacey Ball and Jean-Michel Bombardier, a surprising third place. Now upstairs to Tracy Wilson and Johnny Esau for their thoughts.
It's hard enough to keep your focus in a competition, just wanting to land the jumps and perform well when you're healthy. But when you've just probably been knocked out for a few seconds and then trying to control yourself, I mean, the emotions were overwhelming. And I think Christine and Doug just did a remarkable job.
I can't believe what I saw down there. I can't believe that they can get up and start over again and rethink, get their mindset, rethink, go back to the beginning, remember every step they had to do and to do it, and not be afraid that when that moment came, that it happened the first time, that it wouldn't happen the second time. And I think that this is, you know, this sport doesn't get enough credit for being as difficult as it really is. And this was, unfortunately, one example of how this is explained to the world.
All right, let's go down to Rod and Debbie.
Well, our hearts are beating just like everybody else's is tonight. What an emotional day. Jose Chouinard's win, Huffin Ledrae's fall, and Isabelle Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler winning.